Hi, I'm Cameron McKenzie at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and I wanted to talk to you a little bit about struts, and specifically talking about adding some custom tags to your struts applications. In a previous tutorial, I created a simple little Hello World struts application, and I wanted to show you how I could improve it a little bit by adding in some form tags from struts. So in my previous tutorial, I created this handsome little Hello World struts app. You can see you can type in world there, and it then says hello world back to you. And if you type in your own name, it'll actually say hello Cameron if you type in your own name. So it takes a little bit of input. Then it's just kind of a cool little hello world application. It kicks off with an HTML file. It calls on a hello world action class. It then goes to a results JSP, and all of this is controlled through the use of a struts config file, struts.xml, that is in that resources folder. So just a nice little struts application. Now, one thing that's a bit peculiar is I kick it all off with an HTML file. Nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that at all. However, you know, there are these special struts form tags that are available to us, and we can't use those if we use a regular HTML file. But they are available to you if you create a JSP. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to create a little index.jsp file and recreate this index.html page, but do it with a JSP and use those struts form tags. Now, a couple of things you need if you're going to start off a JSP and use the struts form tags. And it's these two lines that are actually in the results JSP already. It's the Taglib directive, which says we're going to use the struts tag, and then just the page directive that says this is a page that's going to create and generate HTML. So that's how you kick it off. Now I want to recreate the index.html file here as a JSP, so I'm going to copy all of that content that already existed there, push it in, but I'm going to make a couple of changes. So for example, notice this form tag here, where the action is hello.action. I'm going to replace that with a new form tag, and this form tag is from the struts tag library. I'm going to close that with an end tag there. And you can see here we only have to say action equals hello. We don't have to say hello.action. I guess that's not a huge time saver, but it is pretty cool. Also, we've got this regular submit button, and you know, and struts provides its own custom tag for the input submit. And so there we go. We don't have to say input type equals submit. We just say it's a struts submit element and then provide the value. And of course, there's one for text fields as well. And I'm going to throw that down here. And you notice it's got a couple of things. So it's got the name property. So that would be the same as the name property from the regular input file. It's got the value property. We just want the word world in there to start off. A user can overwrite that. We don't need the type equals text because this tag says it's a text field, so that's not necessary. But one thing that is interesting, before we had a prompt here, please tell me your name. I can actually get rid of that, put that in for the label property, click Control S, and now if I run this whole thing again, well, not again, it's actually the first time because it's the JSP. You notice it now says, please tell me your name. It's got world in there. It's the JSP that's being called this time. I can click the submit button. I can also view the source, and the source is kind of interesting. You'll notice in here, they've actually filled in a bunch of fields for us. They've done the kind of root of the application to the hello world. They've put the method equal to post in. Before, I think we defaulted it to get, so that's an interesting change that they've made. Again, the ID there in the form, looks like they've actually created a table in here for all of this data, so I guess that's needed in order to do the labeling. So definitely a much nicer structure to this page. And then you can actually see here, you know, there's the label attribute, and then, well, you know, the tag just gets turned into a regular HTML tag, so there's nothing crazy there. But it is a little different. It's got its own ID field, value, name, input type text. So kind of interesting. Notice they've got a div around the submit button as well for some styling. And so that's what happens behind the scenes when you start using these custom tags. Now I'll click submit. There we go. Hello world. I'll type my name in, Cameron, submit, and it works that way as well. So, you know, you can see it's just kind of a cool way to implement your pages and take advantage of the Struts custom tags. One other tag I like to always demonstrate is I always like to set up a URL. So let's say I wanted to have a link in my page. You can use the Struts URL tag, and I'll say, hey, I want an action where somebody calls the hello action. So that action is very similar to what we set up in the form. We're gonna call this link the hello link, and if somebody clicks on it, they're gonna send the world to the server as a parameter. So this will kind of act the same way as if somebody clicks submit with the text world in one of the input files. So that's the way you can set up a URL. In this case, it's called hello link. And you can add a parameter to it, world. And then that isn't the actual URL. You have to actually go into your code and add that in. Now, the cool thing here is you don't have to put this as part of a form. You can just throw it into your code anywhere you want to. It doesn't have to be inside that form tag, because this link is going to automatically append world as a parameter to it. And of course, I just have to reference the link's name. So use a little bit of a little bit of an expression here. I want that link in that anchor tag to be the hello link. And notice that hello link maps to that variable name there. We'll just say do the hello world, because the parameter world is going to be passed in. And now I can run this, run as run on server. And notice I get a link here. If you actually look in the bottom left-hand corner here, when I hover over it, you'll notice it says hello.action question mark first name equals world. That's how the server knows to send the parameter world up. See, if I type junk in there, this is still going to say hello world, because this isn't getting processed. I'll click on do the hello world, and notice it now says hello world. So there you go. That's a couple of ways that you can incorporate various Struts form tags into your applications. And there you go. That's how you can add some custom tags to your JSPs, specifically those Struts custom tags, to accelerate some of your form-based development. Now, if you enjoyed that tutorial, head over to theserverside.com. I'm the editor-in-chief over there. We've got lots of great tutorials on enterprise software development. If you're interested in my personal antics, you can follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ and subscribe on YouTube.